Hello and a very warm welcome to our special election series, Battleground 2021, that gets a detailed analysis of election news and views from the poll-bound states. I'm Kriti Mishra, and over the next half an hour, we'll bring you the detailed report of the parties, candidates, and the scenario of West Bengal, where we'll be joined by credible guests and senior journalists. The West Bengal Assembly election is passing through its most crucial phase. 159 seats will go to polls between April 17th and 29th. Voting for 45 seats will be held in six districts in the fifth phase on April 17th. The maximum number of seats in the fifth phase will be 16 seats of North 24 Parganas, 5 seats of Darjeeling, 8 seats of Nadia, 8 seats of East Bardhaman, 7 seats of Jalpaiguri, and 1 seat of Kalimpong. Campaigning ended on 14th April for the fifth phase of West Bengal. With the speculations regarding Election Commission might consider clubbing remaining assembly election phases in West Bengal into one, the ECI today made it clear that there are no such plans. Meanwhile, the Chief Electoral Officer in West Bengal has called for an all-party meeting, asking all political parties to adhere to COVID-19 guidelines mandated by the ECI. In all, 319 candidates, including 39 women, will be vying for the 45 assembly seats spread over six districts during the fifth phase. The Bengal Assembly election started on 27th March. The second phase of voting took place on 1st April, the third phase on 6th April, and the fourth phase on 10th of April. Now, the fifth phase of voting is on 17th April. After this, the sixth phase will be on April 22nd, and the seventh phase will be on April 26th, and the eighth and the last phase will be on April 29th. The counting of votes for all the 294 seats will be held on May 2nd. And joining me on the program, Mr. Jayanta Bhattacharya, senior journalist, and Mr. Sandeep Phukkan, deputy editor, The Hindu. Welcome to Raj Sabha TV, both of you. And Jayanta, coming to you first. Four of eight phases of the Bengal Assembly elections are over. Altogether, voters have decided the fate of candidates in 135 out of 294 seats. The fifth phase has the maximum number of seats going to the polls. Certainly, this is a very crucial phase of the 2021 Bengal Assembly elections.
Yes, indeed. In fact, if you see that it's the hills which are going to vote, and there are two districts which are adjoining Bangladesh. So these will be very important, especially for the BJP, because if you see between 2016 and 2019, the BJP, which had earlier in 2016 Vidhan Sabha or the assembly election, just about less than 10% votes of the total votes polled. In 2019, they were just 3% behind the Trinamool Congress, ruling Trinamool Congress in West Bengal. So they consolidated, and that is when we saw that out of the 42, BJP got 18 Lok Sabha seats in 2019. So 2019 is being taken as the base, wherein if we go by that statistics, 121 assembly seats, the BJP were ahead. If you go by the Lok Sabha results of 2019, out of these, the BJP really did well in these North Bengal areas, wherein there are, if I remember correctly, 8 Lok Sabha seats, out of which 7 went to the BJP. Now, if you break it up again, then this has, apart from Darjeeling, Kershang, Kalimpong, and the other seats that are going to the polls day after tomorrow, there is Alipurduar, Kuch Bihar, where election has already happened. Those also went in favor of the BJP. Here in Darjeeling itself, if you take Darjeeling Lok Sabha, which also went to the BJP, there are six assembly seats which are going to the polls day after tomorrow. Now here, the three seats in Darjeeling, Kershang, and in, one more seat, that is Kershang and Darjeeling. Yes, Darjeeling, Kershang, and Kalimpong. The GJM, that is the Gorkha Janmukti Morcha, is contesting. Both the sides are contesting. Trinamool Congress has not given its candidates over there. So it seems like Mamata Banerjee is trying to get into another pact, which I think we can discuss about it later. So the hills remain an important part in these elections, in the fifth phase. Now, all let right. us come to the other section. That is the
Yes, Motua. Sir, please go ahead. Yes, sir.
The Motua, that is, if we see in Nodia and the other districts, adjoining districts, there the Motua community is very important. In fact, one of the BJP MPs represents this community, and this is where the BJP also hedging its bet. There is about 3 crore, roughly, population of the Motuas, out of which there is, the guess estimate is about 1.6 or 7 crore are voters. So they had always been earlier with the ruling party. They are, as we know, that they have come from erstwhile East Pakistan, as it was known then. And there were atrocities against them because they are what is known as Namashudras, do not have a Varna, but they were facing lots of problems there. So many of them came into India and they settled in this bordering area, especially in Nodia and nearby areas. Now, that will also determine, till now, they were with the Trinamool Congress, before that with the Left Front. But now they think that the BJP with the CAA can guarantee them a better future in India. So we will have to wait and see what exactly happens. That will depend on whether they are or most they are going to vote or not, because one of them is also with the Trinamool.
Absolutely. Jenta, you're making a very important point there. Sandeep, let me take that to you. Will Motua community change the fate of Bengal elections in 2021?
Well, they are certainly a community that the BJP and the Trinamool both are trying to reach out majorly. In fact, some would even read as far as that the recent visit by Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Bangladesh had a significance for the Motua community. So connection was made during that visit. Of course, the visit, official visit, was for the 50th year celebration of Golden Jubilee celebration of the liberation of Bangladesh for the 1971 war. But nonetheless, that connection in the election season, that connection was made, that the BJP is going all out to reach out to the Motua community. As Jayantada very rightly said, one of the sitting Lok Sabha members of the BJP is from the spiritual guru, is from the family of the spiritual guru of the Motua community. But there is another MLA who is still part of Trinamool. So I think it is anybody's guess which way they will go. But most certainly in recent times, since 2019 elections, Kriti, it is fair to say that BJP has a hold over the community. And if that sort of sustains, then most likely that a large chunk of the community's vote will go towards the BJP. Because of the, as Jayantada very rightly said, the Citizenship Amendment Act is a very, very important factor in all of this. As he explained to you, the Motua community, they have been actually, they were relocated from East Bengal post-partition, East Pakistan, that is, post-partition. And after that, even during the, and that movement continued even through after the creation of Bangladesh in 71. And, many of these people, not just in Bengal, by the way, several Bengali Hindu families in Assam, in neighboring Assam, also have a very, ambiguous status with regard to their citizenship. Their residence, fine. They have certain rights, but they are not full citizens. They do not have full rights. So some of them, not all of them. So, the Citizenship Amendment Act is being looked at by the Motua community as an empowering tool. And that is why I think the BJP, if you see that it is one of the pitching points by the BJP for the Bengal elections, as recently as 2 days back in an interview, Home Minister Amit Shah said that as soon as the BJP comes to power in the state, they will notify the rules. Remember, the Citizenship Amendment Act has been passed by the parliament. The rules to implement the act is yet to be notified for a variety of reasons. Soon after it was passed, we saw some protest, and thereafter the corona pandemic set in. So everything got delayed. But the Home Minister, in an interview to, in fact, to the Hindu, quite clearly said that, you know, the if they come to power, they will soon notify the rules. So clearly, Citizenship Amendment Act is going to be a very, very important factor also in making that decision of whom to vote by the Motua community.
Absolutely. So we'll have to wait and watch how that factor plays out. लेकिन जयंता जी आपसे समझना चाहूंगी पांचवें चरण में कौन से तीन अहम मुद्दे और कौन से बड़े चेहरे जिन पर नजर होगी?
सबसे पहली बात है कृति कि तीन में से दो मुद्दों को मैंने पहले ही उस पर बात की थी मैंने. पहला है ये पहाड़ वाली बात जो है गोरखालैंड इशू जो है वो आए दिन खासकर ऐसे ही चुनाव से पहले वो उभर के सामने आ जाती है. तो अभी तक ये माना जाता था कि भाजपा थोड़ा सा सिंपैथेटिक है उनके प्रति, उनकी बातें सुनने के लिए उन्होंने बार बार उनको बुलाया है, होम मिनिस्ट्री में भी बात हुई है, सरकार ने कोशिश की है कि इसको किसी तरह से सुलझाया जाए. इस दौरान क्या हुआ कि धीरे अगर आप देखें शुरू से ही ये कारण है कि भाजपा का हमेशा वहां पर एक जोर रहा, उनके जो जो MP है वहां से चुने जाते थे, खासकर दार्जिलिंग से, चाहे वो SS आलूवालिया हो, आज के दिन में राजू बिष्टा हो, वो हमेशा जीतते थे क्योंकि उनके साथ वहाँ के गोरखा जनमुक्ति मोर्चा जो है वहाँ के जो जिन्होंने ये शुरुआत की थी इस मूवमेंट की गोरखालैंड के लिए, उनका सपोर्ट रहता था. लेकिन आज के दिन में क्या हुआ, शुरू में जो सुभाष घिशिंग ने ये शुरू की थी उनके डिप्टी साहब ने, उन्होंने उनको उनसे प्रश्न किया कि आज तक आपने तो दे ही नहीं पाया गोरखालैंड, तो फिर आप कैसे नेता हो. और उसके बाद ये हाल हुआ कि बिमल गुरुंग ने जब करीब निकाल ही दिया पहाड़ से सुभाष घिशिंग को, और वो हमेशा नीचे माने पहाड़ के नीचे रहे, वापस कभी घर नहीं जा पाए. और बड़ी अजीब सी बात है कि आज एक बार फिर से वही कहानी दोहराया जा रहा है पहाड़ में. बिमल गुरुंग ने जिस डिप्टी को रखा था विनय तमंग, वो अब कह रहे हैं कि बिमल गुरुंग को वो नहीं मानते हैं. तो इस बार जो है तीन सीटों में टोटल जो 6 सीटें वहां इलेक्शन होने वाला है परसों, उसमें से तीन में ये GJM के दोनों साइड जो है एक दूसरे के खिलाफ लड़ रहे हैं पहाड़ में. बाकी जो 3 सीटें हैं जो कि दार्जिलिंग लोकसभा के अंदर आता है ये 6 सीटें, बाकी तीन में 2 में कांग्रेस और 1 में CPM ने जीता था. तो वहां से ज्यादा जो है वो मायने रखेगा ये 3 सीटें जहां पर कि JGM के 2 अलग अलग गुट जो है एक दूसरे के खिलाफ लड़ रहे हैं. दूसरी बात मैंने आपको बताया मोतुआ के बारे में, मोतुआ कम्युनिटी किसको चूज करेगी ये देखना पड़ेगा. तीसरा जो एक और है वो है चाय बगान. चाय बगान की बहुत स्थिति बहुत ही गंभीर थी, बहुत ही हालत खराब था वहां पर. शायद 160 के आसपास जो वहां करीब 5 लाख कर्मी जो है वो डायरेक्टली वहां काम करते हैं, इन्वॉल्व है, और करीब 20-22 लाख जो है इनडायरेक्टली है, डेली वेजेस पर काम करते हैं. तो जनवरी में चुनाव के पहले यही होता है, सरकार बहुत सारे मदद करने को आगे आ जाती है. वहां राज्य सरकार ने जनवरी में यह तय किया कि करीब 15% का जो है बढ़ोतरी की जाएगी उनके, चाहे वो डेली वेज वाले हो चाहे वो रेगुलर सैलरी वाले हो, उनकी जो है जो सैलरी है उसमें 15% का, मेरे ख्याल से 15% की बात हुई थी, बढ़ोतरी होगी. उसके बाद अगर आप देखिए यूनियन बजट में 1,000 करोड़ का एक प्रपोजल दिया गया है वहां चाय बगान के जो लोग हैं उनके मदद के लिए. तो ये तीन चीजें मेरे ख्याल से, इसके अलावा तो घुसपैठ का सवाल है ही, जो बॉर्डर इलाका है बांग्लादेश के साथ वो तो है, लेकिन ये तीन चीजें जो है ये बहुत मायने रखेगी परसों चुनाव में मेरे ख्याल से.
आपने जो दार्जिलिंग की बात कही और JGM की बात कही उस पर संदीप का मत जानना चाहूंगी. संदीप, जैसा कि उन्होंने बताया कि गुरंग की पार्टी को ममता बनर्जी समर्थन दे रही है, वहां पर भी हम फैक्शनलिज्म देख रहे हैं, ऐसे में किसका फायदा किसका नुकसान?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, देखिए बड़ा विचित्र हाल है क्योंकि बिमल गुरुंग एक जमाने में सुभाष घिशिंग को बाहर निकाले थे. सुभाष घिशिंग जो लेफ्ट वामपंथियों का एलाय हुआ करते थे, एक उनका एक ऑटोनोमस काउंसिल है जो गवर्नमेंट विद इन गवर्नमेंट. तो बंगाल के चाहे ममता बनर्जी और वामपंथियों में चाहे कितना भी मतभेद हो, लेकिन दार्जिलिंग जो है एक क्राउन है, जिसे इंग्लिश में कहते हैं इट्स अ क्राउन, नन ऑफ द पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज वॉन्ट टू पार्ट विथ. They want to keep that crown. तो चाहे बाम फ्रंट हो चाहे ममता बनर्जी का पार्टी हो, वो लोग सेपरेट गोरखालैंड नहीं मानते. आपको पावर दिया जाएगा लेकिन अलग से स्टेट बना के नहीं देंगे, ये शुरू से उनका रवैया रहा. जहां तक बीजेपी का सवाल है, बीजेपी ने शुरू में बहुत ही सिंपैथेटिक थे और वो क्योंकि वो ये आम तौर से माना जाता है कि वाजपेयी जी के सरकार में झारखंड और छत्तीसगढ़ क्रिएट हुए थे, तो वो छोटे राज्यों के पक्ष में हैं, वो छोटे राज्यों के पक्षधर हैं, तो इसीलिए शायद जब अगर इनकी सरकार होगी तो ये गोरखालैंड एक नेचुरल आउटकम होगा, लेकिन वो हुआ नहीं वो। और अब आहिस्ते आहिस्ते गोरखालैंड का डिमांड तो चल ही रहा है, लेकिन पॉलिटिक्स भी उतने ही चल रहा है। दो विभाजन मतलब दो वो हो चुका है, जो तमांग ग्रुप है वो फिलहाल रूलिंग पार्टी एट द सेंटर जो है उनके साथ है, और जो बिमल गुरुंग वो उनको उनके खिलाफ केसेस भी लगे थे, ममता बनर्जी की सरकार ने लगाए थे और वो गायब थे, मतलब भगोड़े घोषित किए गए थे। आपको याद होगा एक वायलेंस भी हुआ था बहुत कुछ साल पहले दार्जिलिंग में, लेकिन अब मामला ऐसा है कि वो वापस बिमल गुरुंग अपने आप को वापस एस्टेब्लिश करने के लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं पहाड़ों में नेता के बतौर पे, और ममता बनर्जी का समर्थन है। अब देखना पड़ेगा कि कौन सा किसका पलड़ा भारी होगा, लेकिन ये तय है कि पिछले कुछ सालों से जो हिल्स हैं वो पहाड़ी इलाके वो बीजेपी के साथ गए हैं। जो करंट एमपी है राजू बिस्ता वो बीजेपी से हैं, उससे पहले एसएस अहलूवालिया साहब वो भी बीजेपी के थे, तो उससे पहले जसवंत सिंह भी थे, आपको याद होगा जसवंत सिंह जयतदा, आपको याद होगा वो भी थे वहां से, तो मतलब उनका एक पुराना रिश्ता रहा है बीजेपी का। लेकिन ये आपस में असेंबली में क्या होगा वो देखना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि दो गुटों में अब बट चुका है। पहले किसी जमाने में घीशिंग साहब का वो काफी मतलब उनका एक क्लाउट था, उनका कहा माना जाता था टॉलेस्ट लीडर, लेकिन वो स्थिति नहीं रही, अब तमांग और बिमल गुरुंग में ही चल रहा है।
Well, that's an interesting analysis that you're making. Jayanta, do you think the BJP will be able to replicate its parliamentary success in the assembly elections as well, as far as Darjeeling is concerned?
Sandeep has given a nice, concise analysis of that particular area, and he has pointed out the actual situation that is reigning over there. Now, on the one hand is a leader of the GJM who was absconding for a pretty long time, because there were lots of UAPA cases which were slapped against him, so he was in hiding. And he made a dramatic appearance, and it was very clear that he has the sympathy of the state government. Otherwise, he would have been arrested as soon as he surfaced in Kolkata. But on the contrary, we see that he stayed there. He was not arrested. And he has also given his candidates in three main seats, which already the GJM represents in the West Bengal Assembly. And if right after he resurfaced, Mamata Banerjee sent for Binay Tamang and his deputy, who are right now the chairperson of the Gorkha Territorial Government
Council.
That's right. So immediately she sent for them. They had a meeting and she tried to influence him. Not that he was influenced. But right now, Mamata Banerjee is waiting who has the upper hand, and then maybe she will try and have a word with whoever wins. But if we see that in this particular area, which has 54 assembly segments, as I told you earlier, 7 of the 8 Lok Sabha seats, it went to the BJP, where the GJM had their kind of support for them always. In fact, even before, as Sandeep rightly pointed out, that Jaswant Singh also represented the BJP from Darjeeling. Before that, independent candidate Indrajit, he also had the support of the GJM. So every time any party that wants to win from that particular seat has to have the GJM behind them. But this time, the GJM is contesting, not only this time, last time also they contested on their own. And that time they had the support of the BJP. So this time we have to wait and see what happens after the election results come out. But the faction which is right now has the power within the Gorkha Territorial Council, they still is slightly leaning towards the BJP. So with the earlier elections in Alipurduar, Kuch Bihar, now in Darjeeling, it seems that at this point of time, this North Bengal area is slightly in favor of the BJP.
All right, so we'll have to wait and watch and see whether the BJP is able to reap those dividends. But Sandeep, talking about another important aspect, rather interesting aspect, the Congress has intensified its campaign ahead of the phase. West Bengal Congress chief Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary has already ruled out the possibility of extending support to the TMC. How do you see Congress's calculated political strategy in West Bengal?
Well, I don't think, what the interview that he gave, that there is going to be no post-poll alliance, I wouldn't take that very seriously, Kruti.
Okay.
Frankly, because, when you're going into a battle, no general is ever going to say that, look, I mean, if I end up on the losing side, then I'll try and sort of help some other guy who, he's the general in the battlefield. He's leading his troops. So obviously, he will say that we are here to win. Because if he says that I will end up supporting Mamata Banerjee, then voters would say, why would I then waste my vote to you? I mean, there are people who have strong reservations, who may not go to BJP, but they have strong reservations against the Trinamool. So they may look at the third option, which is the third option is the United Front, yes. Samyukta Morcha by left and Congress. So clearly, at this point in time, you don't expect them to openly say that they will support. But I would imagine that their primary aim would be to prevent a BJP government in West Bengal. Should it come to that, I don't see a problem either the Congress or the left extending support to Mamata Banerjee should she require it. That's a post-poll scenario that one will perhaps encounter. Insofar as Congress is concerned, I mean, the fact that this North Bengal used to be, pockets of North Bengal, used to be an equal fight between Left Front and North Bengal used to be a stronghold of the Congress. I mean, Abdul Ghani Khan Chaudhary Barkatda was from this. They still have the MP. His brother is still the Abu Hashim Chaudhary is still the MP. Before that, Mohsen Noor was the MP who's eventually shifted to the Trinamool.
TMC.
So clearly they had some pockets of support, but Congress is, over the years they have lost support. They have also lost many of their leaders defecting to Trinamool. Actually, what Trinamool is facing right now in terms of many of their leaders defecting to the BJP, because BJP has emerged stronger in the state, something similar had happened to the Congress, because ideologically they were not very different. So many of these, a former Congress chief, Manas Muhya, I think, Jayantada, if I am not wrong, he was the Pradesh Congress chief who had left the Congress and joined Trinamool, and he's contesting. So I think that is why Congress is in a much sort of, I wouldn't say decimated, but it is in a much weaker state. And that is why they've sort of come up with this alliance with the Left Front, as well as interesting will be the ISF, the Indian Secular Force,
yes.
The cleric, that Furfura Sharif. Because if he holds it, because he's supposed to hold sway, and if his, if his foray really works on the ground, it could mean more seats than they would anticipate. And if that happens, then it could be trouble for Mamata Banerjee, because she's surely banking on minority votes coming her way and no division in the minority votes. So if Furfura Sharif, if the ISF does well, then it's going to be trouble for Mamata Banerjee. And it could possibly give an edge to this third front, but only in certain pockets.
All right. Jayanta, do you agree? I have last 30 seconds of the show.
Yes, indeed. I'll try to wrap it up as short as possible. In fact, the ISF is certainly an important cog in the wheel. But the problem is the Furfura Sharif, the Pirzadas, who is the descendant of the Pir of Furfura Sharif, they are also divided. The uncle Toha, he is still supporting Mamata Banerjee, not politically, but like that she is doing a good job. But his nephew, that is Abbas Siddiqui, he wants to be a political leader, and he has joined with the United Front, as Sandeep rightly pointed out. So it has to be seen whether, because last time the guess estimate was that Trinamool could lead in the Lok Sabha election because they had around estimated 65% of the minority votes. Now, the rest of the votes, which was garnered by the Congress and the left, will the same vote go to the ISF, or will he be able to eat into the Trinamool Congress 65% Muslim vote?
All right, we'll have to leave it at that. On that note, thank you so much for joining us. So that's all we have for you in this edition. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.